It's not like gold is going to rescue you from the clenches of death. However, there is safety in gold. And we're going to talk about that in this video as we explore. Imagine buying a gold coin, thinking it's going to preserve your wealth, and then the price just tanks $100 in one day. That has probably happened before. I've not seen it drop by that much. But you pay for gold, and it's a lot of money, and then you just lose it right out of the starting gate. That does not sound like something that is going to save you from anything. In fact, that's going to make things worse. But in the end, you've got to take a look at it from a little different perspective and think about the value that gold provides as opposed to the price fluctuations day to day. And that's what we're going to talk about here. Gold is something that has proven itself time and time again. And it has provided that safe haven for generations, for epochs, for millennia even. Through all kinds of different scenarios, societies, cultures, nation states, and the like, gold has stood the test of time. In fact, the metal that you see in these pieces here was likely mined and processed and refined in the modern age. However, it very well could be likely that gold could have come from a myriad of different specters throughout history. Because gold that has been mined and refined and hammered out thousands of years ago would look exactly the same today as it did then. And that's its physical properties. That's what's so attractive about gold, is that it does not change. It does not react. It pays no dividends, but it doesn't need to pay any dividends. It doesn't increase your wealth. It merely preserves it. And by the way, wealth is a very strong word, because whenever one thinks of someone being wealthy, they think of them being rich. But no, that's not really the case. Wealth is a much deeper term in my view. How I interpret wealth is something that is of substance, of long lasting. And that's really what wealth is. And I'm going to now transition here. And we're going to move these away. We're going to take a look at what's inside of this box here. And I'm going to talk about other ways to save in gold. As we unbox this latest acquisition from JM Bullion, actually. And this is a piece that I had purchased just before the year ended in 2022. And we're going to cut into this very carefully to see what the contents are inside here. And right on top, there it is, along with some paperwork. There it is, 1 ounce of gold by the Perth Mint. That's right. And this is a gold coin that I've been eyeing for quite some time, a 2008 Australian kangaroo, the first year that they actually called it that, with a beaded edge, and a beautiful coin indeed. And there are ways to save yourself with gold when buying it using unconventional methods. Now, I'll talk a little bit about that, how to save yourself with gold, with this coin, because I found the opportunity, I've been eyeing it from different bullion dealers for a little while now, and for this design. As most of you know, I am a collector, probably first and foremost. And one of the reasons why I transitioned to gold is because I can find designs that I like for certain coins and then continue to buy them with not as much of a percentage over spot premium as you would for high premium silver coins. You're still paying a premium for some of these pieces, especially when you get a smaller size such as this. But even as such, you can find a pretty good deal if you work at it and look at it long enough and find different shop around with different websites and even your local coin shop may be able to procure and order them for you at a cheaper price from their distributors, such as the case with some of these other coins that you see here before you, all from the Perth Mint, and different eras and different premiums tied to them. You know, a lot of times some of the older backdated coins that come in, you know, if you want that specific year, you're going to pay a little bit more. And I did for this coin. But how did I do that? Well, I just shop around and I looked, and you know what? I decided I'm going to check and see if it's available on eBay. Just check. You know, likely when you buy on eBay, you have to use a PayPal, a credit card. You can't use an e-check option on eBay to be able to save that 3 to 4%. Likely in most cases, it's 4% these days. So that option is not available there, and which means you are going to be paying credit card price for anything that you buy from a bullion dealer, especially in most cases. However, there are exceptions. I have seen some bullion dealers offer gold coins on their website or on eBay for the same or for a little less than the credit card price on their website, which is unusual and odd because they must have some special deal with eBay to make this work, because to be able to use that service, usually their eBay takes a cut. But as power sellers or what have you, or as big bullion dealers, I guess they make that work and can be able to utilize. And you typically, when you buy from eBay, you get the item much faster, especially if it's from a legitimate bullion dealer. They deliver very fast. I've seen that especially with a Scottsdale Mint. You order from Scottsdale Mint from their website, it is painfully slow. But if you buy from their eBay store, you get it very, very quickly. And sometimes the credit card price on the eBay store is less than the credit card price on the website. In this case, it was a very fortunate instance where I got below the cash price, below the e-check price for this gold coin than was offered on JM Bullion's website, which is unusual. So I'm able to take advantage, and I can save myself with gold in this regard, because using my credit card, I get points back, 1.5% back for each of these purchases. And for a gold coin, that's a lot. That money could be used towards other items or emergencies or even another gold coin. I've done that in the past, where I take and I buy gold coins if I can on eBay, and then use those points towards the purchase of another gold coin. You get it for a very heavy discount in due course. A lot of times it ends up being under spot at the time. And so that's one way you could take advantage and save yourself with gold in that regard, by using a credit card. It does not happen too often, but this is one of those cases where you can take advantage of the credit card perks with purchasing these from eBay. And again, that's from an official bullion dealer store. JM Bullion has an eBay site as well too, and that's why I was able to take advantage of this. But gold in general provides that safe haven over the long course of time, over in the case of economic instability, economic uncertainty, which is a point where we are at right now, which is likely going to certainly transition into deeper economic hardship for many people in the world. I don't think there's the path to a great economic recovery or boom even predicted by anybody anytime soon. Supply chains are starting to come back together again, but that does not necessarily translate into great economic activity that we can look forward to in the near future. So we have to keep in mind and have a way to protect ourselves against such a time as what we were seeing right now, with headwinds of further inflation, potential stagflation that is likely going to be coming down the pike. And so gold acts as a bellwether of where things are going down the road. And how does it do that? Well, by maintaining its value with the measure of price. Right now, gold, though it's back a little bit as of the time of the recording of this video, it is still fairly close to $2,000. It's about $90 off from the time that I'm recording this video in the spot price. And it's done a great job over the years of being a good wealth preservation device. And when I think about that, I think of a flotation device, something that keeps you above water financially. You don't want the value of your assets to sink, like this dollar bill. The gravity takes it down, and it could sink because its value is losing more and more each year. And much of it is by design, at the very least 2%, but right now it's at 6.5% from last year, where it was over 7%. Let that sink in to the difference in the value of unsound money versus sound money, which is what we have with gold. Gold is the ultimate hedge against economic instability. It is the ultimate store of value. And I believe that is something that even the most ardent silver stackers should consider adding a little bit of gold to their portfolio. So let me know what your thoughts are in the comment section below about gold and a way to save yourself with gold. And I'd like to extend a multitude of gratitude to all of you for taking the time to watch this video and to encourage you to please rate, share, comment, and subscribe.